A quartet of owls from Take That. He's back tonight, though, and this time he's here as a solo artist with a brand new album. What a pleasure it is to welcome back Mark Owen, ladies and gentlemen.
They're good.
They're a very, very good band.
Well, I've been looking for my band backstage because they've gone missing.
You can't have them. No, they're mine. I own them.
Well, my band have just been hanging outside Sheik's dressing room.
Yeah, looking for a quick hello.
It's really embarrassing. I keep going, has anybody seen my band? And I see them all outside the dressing room pretending to text.
Oh, look, there's Sheik.
There's Niall.
Hello.
Well, I mean, he's quite the figure in music, as you know, down through the years.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It's good to have you back.
It's nice to be back.
And you're back this time without the lads.
I like that it's like, I should have brought a little...
A few more, yes. Teddy bears.
I like the chair, we could have come. It's like the hearing spirit.
Yeah, in the spirit. Oh. But you're on your own now as a solo artist for now anyway. And do you find that peculiar, having spent so much time with the boys recently, that you're back on your own, or are you okay with that? It's a bit weird.
I'm getting more into it.
Are you?
About 2 months ago, because I'd kind of, since we finished the Progress Tour, we were here in 2011.
That's right,
Two nights at Croke Park, which were incredible nights.
Yes, yeah.
But since we finished that tour, I then went home for a bit and we had another baby, me and my lady.
Congratulations.
Yeah, and I didn't kind of do much for a couple of years, just writing songs, really. Yeah. So when I first kind of came out and started doing this after a couple of years, it felt a little bit strange, you know. But I'm getting a bit into it now.
Because I was talking to...
When I put the hat on, did you? It's like you put the hat on, you go, okay, I'm ready.
Oh, it's rock and roll again. Yeah. It's like a uniform, isn't it?
Yeah. I was noticing we have similar haircuts.
Oh, you and me?
Yeah.
Yeah, but in fairness, you're Mark Owen, I'm Tuberty.
No, but we do, though, don't we?
You know, that's where the comparisons end, Mark. But I was talking to Nicky Byrne, who was of Westlife. I'm sure you've met him down through the years. And he's out of that band now, and he's kind of finding his feet in different areas. But he'd just come from the school run. And are you
doing
the school run, going to the gate, dropping the kids? Are you doing that sort of thing?
How many children has he got, Nicky?
He's got two with one on the way.
Right. Oh, really? He's got a third on the way.
Yeah. You should talk to him yourself. Run. I feel
We could chat over coffee. It's funny because, you do the school run in the mornings and then go and get your... once another all dropped off, everybody's happy. You can go and treat yourself to a little cappuccino.
Yeah.
And maybe a croissant.
Yes.
Yeah, if you're really lucky.
Serious glamour now, Mark.
Glamour.
You're moving in the circles.
But I've always got the dog. We have a bulldog called Betty. my little girl, she goes, Betty, because she's just learning, it's the first words, is the name of our dog.
Not mum, not dad.
It's
the bulldog.
Betty. Betty hates going for walks. So in the morning, I've got Elwood on his bike shooting off that way.
Yeah.
And I've got Willow kind of wanting to be carried. My legs are tired.
Yeah.
And then I've got Betty with the brakes on with the bulldog. I mean, the picture in the morning, like, you know, dragging the dog along. But it's
who's
great.
That strange man with the hat?
I don't wear the hat on the
stool. No, of course you don't.
No.
The Art of Doing Nothing is the album. So where did that come from? Where did that come about?
Well, I think when we finished, with Rob coming back in 2011 and doing that whole thing with us, there was a lot of my life was hoping one day we'd do something all together again. Mm. Or my adult life anyway, I was always hoping, I hope one day Rob will come back and do something. And so once he'd done that and we finished that tour, I was a bit like, whoa, there is a space. It was like, okay, you can... I didn't really know what we'd be doing next and what to do next. And I found myself sat at the bottom of the garden. I have a studio down there called the Rabbit Hutch. I have this little circle bench as well. So I sent out a few texts saying, now, if anybody's interested, I'm sat at the bottom of my garden, if anybody, you know. And eventually people started to come down.
Who were you inviting?
Well, just mates, really.
Oh, pals, okay.
Yeah, pals, really. But people who were kind of, two of my friends, Jamie and Ben, who wrote the record with us, they're here.
Yeah.
Outside Sheik.
They're stalking Sheik, You could be doing this act on your own with your guitar, by the way.
I might be doing it on my own. So
they gathered around.
But the whole idea was to get a load of creative people involved around this little circular bench.
Yeah.
Don't know why, but that was almost a nothing. Loads of people involved, so artists, producers, and just try and make something from nothing.
Yeah.
Which
is how it all came
about. Which is how it all kind of came about.
And when you're in the rabbit hutch, your shed,
yes.
And you've got two kids and a little baby floating around, are they knocking on the window going, can we come in now? Or are they told this is forbidden territory?
No, they do come in.
Okay.
Yeah, they after school, they come back in and usually what they like to do is find... I allow myself another treat after my croissant and my cappuccino.
Yeah.
On the way home, I usually buy a bar of chocolate.
Okay.
I think I'll have that later.
Because the chocolate has replaced the cigarettes.
Yes,
you've given up the smokes.
So I've got my chocolate bar for about 3 or 4 o'clock.
I think, right, you devil.
Yeah, but the game is trying to find Dad's chocolate bar. So they usually come down to the studio about 4 o'clock.
And they know it's chocolate time.
See if they can find where Dad has hidden it and then run around the garden.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But actually, the circle bench, I don't know if I told, that used to be a pond.
Oh, right,
a little
okay.
pond at the bottom of our garden. I don't know why I'm telling you this.
That's all right. I'm happy
I'm
to
here.
Talk about your pond.
I'm here.
You're here, we're here.
Get,
it's a chat show, chat away.
I don't get a chance to talk much.
That's okay. I'm all ears.
But we got rid of the pond, but the frogs keep coming back every year.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Just to have his dinner.
So the frogs turn up wanting to go in the pond. So me and Elwood also, we have usually around April, March, April time, we collect the frogs because they all come and start mating at the bottom of the garden.
Great.
Which is nice. And we have a little, like a little bucket, and we put them all in there.
Yeah.
And then, like, once a week, we'll transfer them to the big pond.
Okay.
But it seems like more coming. I think they think it's some, like, holiday excursion for frogs, because more and more keep coming every year.
Yeah. You could recreate Paul McCartney's cartoon video from the frog course with real
that's,
frogs.
Maybe it's
boom,
a sign.
Boom, boom, you know.
Maybe it's a sign. Thing. Maybe that's what the
That's what the message is.
At, yeah.
Have you played the Other Boys and Take That, your album? Would you give them
I
a preview?
Have.
And how did that go down?
It went down well.
Would they...
I tell you, the funny thing is because we didn't get a hard copy, so you stream them now, so
yeah.
I can send them a version of the
email
album.
Email or whatever, yeah.
Yeah, but from my label, they streamed them, and I got a couple of complaints because they could listen to it for 2 days.
All right, okay.
And then it cut
and
off.
And then it's gone.
And so then it disappears off. Though, you've got to buy it now.
What did Gary Barlow, X Factor judge, say about it? style icon, X Factor Judge Gary Barlow, or Barry Garlow.
I had a style icon. Is it crossed over to here as well?
How did that happen?
How did that happen?
Because you knew.
I was moving the frogs, the bottom of the garden, writing a record.
As you do.
I come out, and then all of a sudden Gary Barlow's a style icon. Like, how did that happen?
All it took was the length of time to move a box of frogs.
A box of frogs. In that time, he'd done it. I don't
so
know how he did that.
Because how was he perceived
well,
fashion-wise
well,
in the band?
He's never really been that interested at all. Like, and trying to get him, he always goes, oh, Mark, you sort me out. Tell me what to wear. Or I'm not bothered, you know. He likes his comforts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, I don't know what's... I'm really, like, surprised. He came round to my house, like, the other day. And I thought, oh, guys, he's coming round. That'd be nice. And when he turned up, I was like... Oh my word.
Yeah.
I felt like a bit underdressed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I did.
See, it's all changed.
It's all changed.
Changed utterly. Can I ask you about you just mentioned Croke Park there, which is about 80,000 people. One night, the next night, another 80,000. And then you're a solo artist. And I know you play, say, for example, a few cheeky, I don't know what the right word is, but little preview gigs. What's the word for you?
Like previews. I think I've read the calling them like secret gigs.
Secret
did
gigs.
A couple of little acoustic gigs.
Okay, so that'd be quite a small number of people.
Yeah, about 15.
50.
20. 30, 40
Gee,
people.
That's an enormous,
enormous
shift of a mindset, to say the least. So how do you adjust?
Well, it's been really helpful for me because, again, it's just, for me, I'm coming back here in June doing some shows, but it just kind of gets you back into the kind of mould of what you're about to do, you know. So it was really great. We did one in Manchester and one in London, and there was about 40 people at the one.
Were your parents at them?
That was sold out, the one in Manchester. It was about 40 people.
40, so that was it. Was that a phone box?
Yeah. do you know the way you can tell if people aren't listening or aren't enjoying it when there's 40 people?
Yeah,
you can
imagine.
Kind of go, she's not really
digging
this.
You could probably
she's
read.
She's thinking, when are you going to introduce Gary Barlow?
Oh, no.
Style icon.
Style icon.
Yeah.
You could probably read their text messages.
You could probably read it.
But, and your mum and dad would have gone to one or two of those,
mum and dad
nice.
Came to the Manchester
That's quite
one.
Sweet.
Yeah, it was It was a nice surprise, yeah.
Because your dad's a musician, isn't
he? My dad is, yeah. He tells me he comes and plays in Ireland. He's done gigs, he's toured around here over his life. He's a guitarist, and he's done lots of like Irish country music. It's his thing.
So maybe that bit of that might have been in the background when you were a youngster.
Well, I remember always going watching them when we were growing up. We'd go to like bars and wherever my dad was playing around Manchester. There was quite a scene. And I remember it was amazing because my dad would be on stage, but we were allowed to stay up till really late.
Yeah.
I don't know, it probably was like midnight or something.
That's a treat when you're a kid, of course.
Amazing, yeah. And we're just running around, having the best time.
Tell me a little bit about the future then. Obviously, the immediate future is you solo album, single, which we're about to hear you perform now, and then we'll be seeing you back here live. We'll talk about that as well. Take that then in the broader scheme of things. You're going to be back for more with the boys, are you?
Yeah, we're planning on going back into the studio.
You are.
To make another record. Yeah, everybody wanted a bit of time away, which, you know, I think for us as well as a band, we've kind of done 6 years quite straight on, really.
Yeah.
And so everybody wanted a bit of time, but I think everybody's getting a bit excited about... In January, we're planning on coming back to some stuff. And they seem, you know, quite excited about
it. Is that a Take That with Robbie vibe?
Well, we hope so. Yeah. I think it... Oh, depends really, because I don't know what Rob's full schedule is.
Okay.
I mean, it's when we see you in Jan, it's like everybody's in.
Okay, so it's considered a given.
At the moment, it's like everybody's, but you never know. Come January, until we're all in the studio, you just don't know.
I'm dying to hear the new song on the show tonight. You've dedicated to, let's mention them because you've talked about them earlier on. It's dedicated to the kids, isn't it?
I guess it is really. Well, to everybody, really. But when I first wrote this song, you have those moments you go, oh, I think this is really special. And I remember running into the house and I put it onto a CD.
Yeah.
And I ran into the house and was like, Em, have I listened to this? I think it's a really good song. And I put it on and they had a little dance. Selwood and Willow.
God.
Did like a little waltz around the house to it, and I thought, oh, well, that's even just for that moment, it was worth it. Really.
Passed a critical test.
Passed a critical test.
It's been great to have you on the show again, Mark. Looking forward to hearing you singing now.
Thank you.
Have a good day. Nice to see you. Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Mark Owen, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Okay, Mark will be performing in the Olympia Theatre, good venue for him, in Dublin on June the 19th. Later on next month, of course, which is tomorrow, I think. And his new album, The Art of Doing Nothing, is out on June the 7th. But now to perform his current single, it's called Stars, which we welcome once again, Mark Owen, ladies and gentlemen.
Gonna build a rocket anytime you want it. Paint it pretty colors. Gonna light it up and take us to the moon. That's what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm gonna save up all the paper. Gonna need it later. Maybe take a minute to get in my head. Directions all the way. You want to get away. I'm taking you through the eyes of the black hole and the open door. Through the cracks in the paper. From the top of the empire to a state unknown. If I say that I'm leaving, just got to hang on. Cause we're just stars trying to get back to where we're from. One by one, we're gonna leave this planet. So don't look back, cause you know that it's all just time. When you got nothing on your mind, you made it somewhere in the future. Talk about forever. Take yourself a picture. Waiting in the rain for a postcard from the sun. The one that never comes. The one that never shows. The one that never. It filled in something from the heart of the wreckage. Another zone. I'm losing our minds. I think we've got vertigo. The top of the empire to a state unknown. If I tell you I'm leaving, you just got to hang on. Cause we're just the soldiers come. When you got nothing on your mind, you need it.
Mark Owen, ladies and gentlemen, and the lads. Thanks, Saul. Thank you so much. See you next time. All right, quick reminder of a competition for you at home now, courtesy of the National.